Just give the dancers a second to catch their breath. Hold on.
Oh, it's good to see you back, Stavros Flatley. Have a drink. Catch your breath.
Makes us feel. But I want to say, this show is amazing. We've been all over the world, we've done things and places we never thought we'd be, and it's because of you guys. Thank you. I watched him grow up from here to here, and I ain't never been so proud as I am now. Thank you so much. And thanks for everything.
We've got the judges.
I know, but I've got to thank my dentist in Baffles. He's amazing. I've got the same team as Simon now. Look. Dr. Fafaris in Baffles. Amazing. Well,
so, thanks to the Pathos dentist, judges, finally, it's over to you.
Look, I've wanted to say this to you for years. I've really wanted to thank both of you for everything you've done. No, forget me. I want to be able to thank you, and there's one way I can do this.
Because it's going to sound weird, but it's true. You've just been given Simon Cowell's golden buzzer. How do you feel?
Whenever you need us, forever we'll be there. If I have to come on this stage on a mobility scooter, I will come.
Can you do one more thing for us? Can you come back and perform for us in the grand final of Britain's Got Talent, the Champions?
It would be an honour and a pleasure.
Stavros Flatley, we'll see you in the final.
Let's hear it one more time, Stavros Flatley.
What's your name?
Faith.
Faith, how old are you?
12 years old.
Wow. And where are you from?
I'm from Swindon.
Are you feeling nervous?
No.
Nervous and excited.
What did you think when you woke up this morning?
I was like, oh my days. Is this even real? I started pinching myself. Oh, this isn't real. I can't be doing this yet.
Got a great personality.
Can I ask you a question? Have you ever had moments when you've lost your confidence? I'm really curious.
I have lost my confidence a little bit with, like, a bit of negative energy from different schools, from,
yeah.
Like, because... But my mum and my dad, they helped me get through that, which is why I'm here today. So...
OK, my darling. Well, good luck. This is your moment.
Thank you.
She's so cute.
Sleep, yeah, right now, worry about.
She's got fat.
Occasionally, and it is very occasionally on this show, someone comes onto the stage, you think they are born to be a superstar.
Thank you.
You know what I love about you, Faith, is that I absolutely love your personality.
Thank you.
And you talked about the support you had from your mum and dad. Then you see the support you've had from 3,000 people, and just to give you a little bit more support, I'm going to give you one of those. Sing the phone book.
My heart is beating.
Enjoy every moment.
Hey, Daddy.
Hello, Dad. Hey, well done. Hey, amazing.
Thank you very much.
That was such an amazing audition.
That's amazing.
Thank you so much, Simon.
It's an absolute pleasure. Brilliant. I asked the question if you've ever had any negativity, because when I grew up, I had that as well. And the most important thing is they never get to you. And when you're as good as you are, you win. You know, it kind of gives you that strength and determination. So if anyone ever says anything negative, remember this moment, OK?
Oh, my God, that's so amazing. Thank you so much, Simon.
It's an absolute pleasure to meet you both.
Thank you.
You will start.
Very well, thank you. What's your name?
I'm Jack.
Nice to meet you, Jack.
I'm Dad, I'm Tim.
Hi, Dad, Tim. Aw, aren't you adorable? Where are you guys from?
We're from Norfolk, Norwich.
How old are you, Jack?
I'm 12.
12, and how long have you been singing with Dad?
Since I was about 5.
Really? And Tim, is this what you do for a living?
I play, I'm a full-time dad, really, to Jack, Lily, and Gabrielle and Kimberly.
Hi! Are you feeling nervous?
A little bit, but I'm really excited.
Do you think you could win this?
It's my favourite thing to watch on TV, so it would be absolutely incredible to win.
Good answer.
Do you have a favourite judge?
I like Simon especially because... I like Simon especially. Because I like watching his best insults.
Okay. They're good, aren't they?
They are really good. They're funny.
OK. Probably not best to answer that question again. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
What's the song?
This is a song called The Lucky Ones. Jack and I write together, and this is one of ours.
OK, can you tell me what it's about?
It's, we've all had family losses and things like that, and as a father and son, it's a kind of father-son song, family song. It's about us. It's just about being
how
so
lucky we are to have what we have.
Oh, well, you seem adorable, and we wish you guys the best of luck.
Thank you.
Jack, this says it all. Got Talent.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, that's very nice of you to say. So what are your names, boys?
My name's Charlie.
And my name's DeAndre. And together we're Baz and Melody. Bam.
What's the dream with you two guys?
I just want to deliver it to you people. I just want to give an awesome performance.
I get ya.
What does your mum and dad do for a job?
My mother's a personal trainer, and my father's a stonemason.
Stonemason!
Hey, bro!
And you?
My mum's a cook in a school.
Dinner lady, yo!
And, my stepdad, he owns his own company.
He's a businessman, yeah!
Can I just say one thing? Alicia, I love you so much. You're my inspiration.
He fancy Alicia. He don't like Amanda.
Amanda, you're beautiful as well.
He is lying.
Boys, can I just ask you, what are you singing?
Well, it's Hope by Twista and Faith Evans, but it's a bit of a twist in the rap because I wrote it myself.
What's the song about?
It's about anti-bullying.
Anti-bullying?
Yeah, because it's something that I feel deep about, so. I started rapping because I went through a very hard time in primary school. I was getting bullied.
As a parent, it's one of the hardest things to see your child upset and going through emotional turmoil. It is hard, very hard.
When I used to be, like, down in the dumps, I used to write down my raps. I could express myself through what I was writing down.
I was very happy with the way Leandre dealt with it. He actually stood up to the bully and resolved the situation.
I moved school and it's a much better environment for me. I love school. I really do love school, it's amazing.
I'm very proud of him, very proud.
The first time we met, we really clicked. It was just an automatic connection. Like, I didn't think it'd be like that.
We're brothers.
I think music's made him a lot stronger. If it wasn't for his music, he wouldn't be as confident and as cheeky, you know? It just helps him a lot.
We really want people to listen and hear our lyrics that are in our song.
OK, good luck.
Thank you. I feel so alone, I'm just a kid, how can I take it on my own? I'm crying too many tears, yeah, writing this song. Trying to fit in, where do I belong? I wake up every day, don't want to leave my home. My mama's asking me, but I'm always alone. Too scared to say, too scared to holler. I'm walking to school with sweat around my collar. I'm just a kid, I don't want no stress. My nerves are bad, my life's a mess. The nature call me, they hurt real bad. I want to tell my mom, she's having trouble with my dad. I feel so trapped, there's nowhere to turn. Come to school, don't want to fight, I want to learn. So please, Mr. Bully, tell him what I've done. You know I have no dad, I'm living with
just
my mom.
Hopeful, yes I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it, let it take you away.
I like these two.
I do. Hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
Why do you trip back a single day? I didn't ask to be born, but now I have to pay. I ain't got no money, you take all I have. When they give it to you, I search for my bags. I feel so scared when you shout me down. You kick me, punch me, throw me to the ground. When I ask you, yo, what have I done? You hit me again, I make fun of my mom.
I'm hopeful, yes I am hopeful for today. Take this music,
check it out.
Use it, let it take you away. And be hopeful, hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know it ain't easy, but that's okay, just be hopeful.
What I wear is all I have. We lost a home, I'm living from a bag. Yo, Mr. Bully, help me please, I'm flesh and blood, accept me please. Hey, Mr. Bully, I don't know what to do. My mind, it can't explain what it did to you. Mr. Bully, take a moment, please. I'm a single day, you bring me to my knees.
Yes, I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it. Let it take you away. And be hopeful, hopeful. And he'll make a way.
I know
it ain't easy, but that's okay. Just be hopeful.
Oh,
seems like we hardly need to critique you. It went so well, but let's have some comments. Amanda.
I'm just so happy for you. Your voice is beautiful. We all were in tears. So well done.
Thank you so much, thank you.
The minute you started that verse, it actually brought a tear to my eye. It was really, really moving.
Alicia, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be rapping, so yeah, thank you so much.
Oh, that's really sweet.
Two young kids like yourself to come out and sing about something that really affects you, do it in a style that's completely yours, is a really rare thing. That's why you got that golden buzzer today.
Thank you so much.
Well, you know what? I've heard some monstrous songs today and I just was literally losing the will to live. But you know what? I listened to every word. Did this stuff happen in your life?
I got bullied a bit when I was younger, but...
But not anymore?
Yes, so it's all gone now, yeah.
I think that record could be a hit, I really do. I really, really like you two.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
That's it, we'll see you in the live show.
Thank you for this amazing opportunity.
Come here, you two. Oh,
amazing.
Amazing. You're Calum, Jade's brother. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, well, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
I'm 26, I'm from Hull. And I'm singing a cover of a song by Robin.
I love Robin.
Yeah. It's Dancing on My Own, but it's a bit slower.
Okay. Whenever you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Somebody said you got a new friend. And does she love you better than I can? And there's a big black sky over my town. I know where I bet she's around. Stilettos and broken bottles, I'm spinning around in circles. And I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm right over here. Why can't you see me? Oh, oh, oh. And I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy. Lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here. I just came to say goodbye. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, and I'm giving it my all. I'm not the guy you're taking home. Lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here.
surreal.
I'm really mean that. Hold on.
Oh my God, Simon!
Callum!
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, you?
What's your name?
Sarah Ikumu.
Okay, Sarah, where are you from?
Milton Keynes.
Okay. And how old are you, Sarah?
I'm 15.
Wow. Okay, tell me the song you think is the right one for you and why you've chosen it.
I think And I'm Telling You is the best song for me because it shows my vocal ability the best.
One of the biggest songs in the world.
Yes.
And you want to take that one on? Let's do it.
And I'm telling you, I'm not going to win. You're the best of me. I'll ever know. There's no way I can ever go. No, 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 no way. No, 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 no way. I'm not living without you. Yes, I'm not living without you. I don't
Sarah, I've heard this song a lot. And it started off really well. I thought, yeah, this girl's great. And then it's like you became possessed halfway through. It was quite incredible. And for someone of your age, to stand on this stage with all the nerves and all the pressure to absolutely not just nail the song, you made it your song.
Thank you.
That's what you want to hear.
I'm absolutely thrilled that you got a golden buzzer. I mean, it was mind-blowing. I couldn't believe that you were only 15. Congratulations.
You are not allowed to have that much talent at your age. It's insane. And I didn't press that golden buzzer because I wanted Simon to press that golden buzzer. Because I want you to go far, and I think Simon can help you because you are a superstar.
Thank you so much.
Yes! David?
Yeah, it was all right. No, it was fantastic, Sarah. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Most importantly, enjoy this. I'm thrilled for you and your family. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Really been an amazing audience. Thank you very much.
Simon Cowell's Golden Buzzer Act, how do you feel about that?
That's a dream come true.
Is it?
He was the one.
Oh my goodness, hello.
Hello, Alicia.
How are you?
I'm good, I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big-name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiance, We've got a little boy called Roman, who's here as well. And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. Okay, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Coach!
This. I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I am a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, Kujo, come here. Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? The coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. Dad! Can't you get it yourself? It was 1 p.m., but it got dark real quick. The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes. I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows. 4! But there's only one person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long. Go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones. Yeah. So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you.
right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open? I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence.
Nice.
I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met. He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy. Like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride. You can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently. Me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter.
Love it. Okay.
The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5.
Very good.
My name's Kojo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Joe, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'm so happy right now. I've always respected you. My respect level for you has just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny.
Yeah.
You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. But I love you. I really get it.
I have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You've just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you. Enjoy this. Thank you.